talk today about the push kick. Okay, now the push kick is a very simple move. You guys probably seen it. Some styles call it a front kick, but they're actually different techniques. With the push kick, right, you can use it a couple different ways. Obviously, you're always going to be in your stance, whether you're southpaw or orthodox, there's always going to be a lead leg. Okay, if you're going to use the lead leg push kick, it's good for maintaining distance. Like, Eli's already a certain distance away from me. This lead leg, if I want to keep him there to throw attacks at the end of my reach, I'm here and follow up that way. Okay, that's with the lead leg. Now, when you guys throw push kicks, lead or rear leg, you want to bring your knee up, chamber high, and extend out, shoulders back. Okay, see how my shoulders shoot back? It acts as counterbalance. You don't want to try to stand up like this because it's a little awkward on your balance. So let your body lean the way it naturally leans. You counterbalance yourself perfectly. Okay, so I'm going to use the lead leg, again, to maintain distance. I'm going to come up and then follow up, if I so choose, with punches or kicks. I'm usually hitting with the ball of my foot or the heel. The heel requires a greater deal of flexibility to really hit someone with your heel. So I don't do it that way. Okay, but those are the main targets, either the heel or the ball of your foot. Now, what I find for creating distance with push kicks, again, creating distance, meaning someone's really close to me, closer, it's really hard for me to get that lead one off. Even though it's close to him, it's really hard for me to come in here because he probably jams me. So when I want to create distance, I tend to use the rear leg. So I'll be here up, okay? I've had people darn near chest to chest on me, and I can still get that off, okay? You know, some people's theories on push kicks are different. I find that if I want to maintain distance, I set up combinations off that, use the lead. If I want to create distance, I'm getting suffocated, I'm getting smothered, I feel using the rear is the best option. Same mechanics, it's covering more distance, so based on physics, it's going to be a lot more powerful. Up, boom. Okay, now in terms of where you want to hit on a push kick, I like to go for the stomach or breadbasket area, because that couple well-placed ones, guys start sucking air, it's huge. You know, I've sparred guys a lot better than me, and I managed to take their air away, because I can land repeated shots to here. Okay, body, you know, throwing these to the body of your face is pretty much the only practical application. You know, roundhouse kicks, yeah, you can slam them into the legs and chop away that way. That really doesn't work. And it might be misconstrued as you're trying to break their knee. Okay, so maintain distance, lead leg. Create distance, rear leg. Okay, same thing, I'm going to hit with the ball or my heel, lean back to counterbalance. The push kick is one of my favorite attacks. Very versatile, very simple. Practice it. It'll be a great weapon in your arsenal.